The feeling of helping somebody is an unbelievably powerful motivator. It's what drives everybody, from surgeons to all aspects of medicine in general. It's a great feeling. You can't beat it. Rotator cuff tendon injuries is a large spectrum, which is actually fairly common, unfortunately. These muscle tendons act in concert to stabilize the shoulder. The problem happens when they tear. It's very difficult to get that tendon to heal back to bone. So we're working on trying to get the body's own ability to heal itself by taking what we call mesenchymal stem cells, which we can get from the bone marrow, and trying to concentrate them and reimplant them into the area.
Adult stem cells are a multipotent cell, which means that these cells have the capability of turning into bone and tendon. We hope that the stem cells can divide, populate the area, and enhance the repair.
We also do work in the biomechanics lab, which is a lab designed to test the strength of these repairs and how durable those repairs are over time.
The shoulder simulator can mimic any humanly possible motion. Once the simulator takes over, we can record the data of what the forces are that are seen by the shoulder. That will give a surgeon confidence to tell a patient, start moving your arm. Nobody that we know of is doing this reverse total shoulder arthroplasty on cadavers. In a regular classroom, you bring in saw bones, and some saw bones, you know, mimic the properties of a bone. Cadavers give you the real world.
Finally, we look at what we call patient-centered outcomes to see if there's any area that we can capitalize on.
In the post-operative period, we're very vigilant with patients who've had rotator cuff repair.
And the people that haven't used their arm in 10, 15 years and you're able to provide that function to them, that's probably the big thrill. I finally figured it out.